my dearest brother. As my hour draws near, I think of the years spent together in Valentin Manor. They were grim and hard, a crucible meant to forge us into things harder than the hulls of steamships, but less than men. In those years of darkness, I would have stumbled and starved, but your and Lana's acts of kindness were the sole lamps which lit my way through the tunnels and dungeons of our father's will. Were it not for you, I would have died long before unearthing the art that nourished and sustained my soul. And even with all the hues the gaslights of this world could illuminate, my survival would have meant nothing were it not for the purpose you gave me. As the one they call my wife comes for me, tracking those with my gift as surely as her wolf tracks the scent of the unlawful, with results just as deadly, I find solace in the memories of our conversations. None of the servants cared for the books I read, but you were always willing to ask what insights had been gleaned, what ideas they gave me, what I wanted to paint or write next. In spite of everything, you were always gentle with me, and caring, and patient, though you knew not how to express it openly. I remember that night when our father lashed out at me for my failure to endure Uncle Vicarian's combat training. You and Lana were the only ones with the courage to be my shield, and to salve the wounds to my psyche after the fact, in spite of those he inflicted on you for defying his will. My art has long been an escape from the dreariness of this world, from the confines imposed on me. But the truth is catching up to me, and I find myself soon to face a fate from which there is no escape, and bonds which will outlast the burning of my mortal being. I fear the electroplasm. I fear the pain, and the choking suffocation of those in agony below me. I fear that with my ghosts unable to rise, I will never again feel the comfort of a warm bed or fulfilling meal. Never again lose myself in story or the act of creation. Never again visit the vistas of dream and the lost worlds of light and color and life within. But I face all that willingly. For I know my life and my death have served a greater purpose. By now you know that the inspiration for my greatest works did not come solely from books and study, from tapestries and libraries and galleries. While my sickly body slumbered, I escaped to visit the dreams of others, and saw things there, memories and ideas of light and of hope, and of the concept I still struggle to understand, that which the old tomes describe as love. But I've also seen forbidden things, secrets of darkness, of all-consuming avarice, and of ambition's murder of that which should have lived. In one fateful, forbidden dream, I found the key which opened the door to my demise, which can also open the door to your and Lana's freedom, which can unlock the cell that incarcerates all that remains good in our family, and which can unlock, finally, our revenge. You can find that key, you must find that key, in a place you always go, but can easily forget. I know you have locked away your compassion and the things that you have been forced to see as weakness. But I visited your dreams as well, and seen there something that you yourself have forgotten, buried and sealed memories of a carefree time with Mother, of the warmth of the sun on your face and your limbs, eyes closed but still feeling its glowing presence, and the peace and comfort that it brought. Rod, you are more than the cruel tool that Father tried to make you. As long as you live, that warmth upon your face still exists, perhaps buried, perhaps unseen, but not dead. Let the light of what is right guide you. You alone can shine light on what Father has hidden from the world. Good luck. Always your brother, Aesop Valentin.